So if I sound a little bit sick in this video, that's because I am a little bit sick in this video, but just stick with me. I think you're gonna enjoy this one. Today's video, I'm going to show you how to recreate a few transitions based off of videos by Brandon Lee. And if you're not already following Brandon Lee, then you're just missing out. As far as I'm concerned, he's one of the absolute best filmmakers on YouTube right now. And it's not just that his work is well produced, but he's a really great storyteller, and all of the techniques he uses are very creative. That being said, let's get into this tutorial, starting out with the effect that I notice being used the most often in his videos, which is this kind of modified masking transition. To make this, you're gonna need two shots. The first shot should be not necessarily static, but it shouldn't have a lot of camera motion or a lot of camera shake. And the second shot should include something passing in front of the camera, like a pole or a wall. Just something that you can use to mask that shot over the first one. I'll start out by just making a regular masking transition. So I'll just mask out that object that passes in front of the camera in such a way that it reveals the scene around it. Then just move that second clip onto the track above your first clip and drag it over so that when the first clip ends, the mask on the second clip covers the entire frame. At this point, congratulations, you've created a regular masking transition, but there's one more detail that Brandon Lee adds to his, and that's that he just keyframes the first clip to move over to follow that mask. And to add that final detail, all you need to do is, depending on the shot, keyframe either the scale or the position, and then move it to stay behind the mask. For me, this extra detail just makes the entire transition a little bit more smooth, like the camera's actually moving. The second effect I want to show you is this one, where the camera starts with one angle, and then just flips completely over and rotates to reveal another shot. And this kind of blew my mind the first time I saw it, because it's just a really trippy, kind of interesting effect. And this could also be a really interesting and useful way to transition between a shot of a character and a shot of what that character is seeing. For this effect, I'm shooting my footage using a gimbal, in my case the Zion Crane V2, and I'm gonna put that into pan tilt follow mode. So when I tilt the crane down, the camera's gonna follow it instead of staying still. I'm also filming in 4K, and it's important for this effect that you shoot in the absolute highest resolution that you can, because we're gonna be scaling into the shot in post. Basically, all I'm doing is starting with a pretty wide angle, then walking towards my subject, and slowly flipping the camera over to eventually reveal that final angle. This is a somewhat tricky camera move to pull off, especially without getting your feet in the shot, so you might need to give it a few tries before you get it right. Now that we've shot our footage, we can bring it into our editing software and finish it off with a quick animation. Basically, I'll just watch through my footage, and when I see the camera start to tilt down, I'm gonna add a keyframe for the scale and rotation. Then I'll move to the point where the camera is completely upside down and change the rotation to 180 degrees. After I've done that, I'm just gonna go back through my footage and find the point where the rotation is at 90 degrees, and then scale the image up so that it fills the entire frame. As you can see, we're digitally scaling into the image pretty significantly, so that's why it's important to not only shoot in the highest resolution you can, but also be careful with your framing, since we're gonna be cropping in later. In Brandon Lee's video, this effect is combined with a screen replacement, and I'm not gonna go over the entire process for creating a screen replacement because it's pretty complex and really depends on the software you're using, but I will give you a brief overview. Basically, what I'm gonna do is track each corner of the screen individually and then attach each one of those tracks to a point layer. Next, I'll add an effect called quad warp or corner pin to the footage that I want to be on the screen. And then using that quad warp or corner pin effect, I'll attach each of the corners to the corresponding point layer. Now, of course, there are other ways to create a screen replacement. Like if you have Mocha, then you can use a 3D planar track, but this is the method I like to use. The next effect isn't even a transition, but it's super simple and Brandon Lee uses it all the time, so I couldn't just not include it. And that's just this dolly zoom or vertigo effect or whatever you want to call it, where the foreground and background appear to be like growing and shrinking at different rates.
All you have to do for this is just film a shot where the camera is moving either forwards or backwards, preferably on some sort of gimbal or stabilizer, and then just animate it to do the opposite in editing. So if you have a shot that moves backwards, then animate it to zoom in, and if it's moving forwards, animate it to zoom out.
And just like the rotation effect we talked about earlier, this is a case where it's important to shoot in the highest resolution you can, since we're gonna be scaling into the shot later. The final transition you might see in one of Brandon Lee's videos is this one. It's just a LumaFade, but unlike most LumaFades, it's not tacky or distracting. And that's for a couple of different reasons. For one, he's using a higher tolerance or softness on the effect, so he doesn't have those harsh edges on the transition. And it's also a match cut, so we're transitioning from one shot of a face to another shot of a different face. These are actually techniques that I covered a couple of weeks ago in a different video all about making your LumaFades look better, so I'll link that video right up here. It's only 60 seconds long. But that being said, even if you turn around and use every single one of these transitions in your videos, you're not gonna be Brandon Lee, because what's important about his videos is the storytelling and the creativity. It's useful to learn about these techniques and replicate them or even use them in your own videos, but it's important not to think that they're gonna make your videos good or make them like someone else's. So no matter what, just remember to stay creative with how you're using these effects or any other effects for that matter. But that's all for this video, and in last week's video I talked about color grading, and I asked you all to comment and let me know how you color grade your own videos. So here or a bunch of those comments. But that is all for today's video. I hope you learned something from it, and if you did, do feel free to share your support by leaving a like on the video, sharing it with your friends, or even subscribing to my channel. I upload 2 new filmmaking tutorials every single week. But that's all for this one. Keep creating, and I'll see you in the next one.